G'day mate. In today's episode, I'm going to be talking about grant applications. What is a grant application? You're probably not asking because you already know. Well, I'm glad you asked. A grant application, basically, it's just a way for you to get free money from the government to make something with. Usually it's like an album. You can get grants for touring, like internationally. You get grants for just about everything. Look at what your state has. Just type in like, you know, Victoria musician grants and you can get yourself like tens of thousands of dollars for your band. Whether that's for touring, for making your own album. I have seen a few COVID like relief funds going about and a few friends have got those as well, which is really cool. Basically with a grant, it's a lot of effort and a lot of time to make these grant applications. So what we're gonna do today is we're gonna take a grant application that we've already been successful with and I'm gonna kind of take you through at least the way I thought about writing the grant application. So basically, yeah, I'm definitely not an expert at writing grants, but I'm probably the best you got. Unless you want to pay someone, because there are people that you can pay money to and they'll write your grant application for you. But what I'll do today is I'll just tell you how I go about writing it and then maybe you can take something from it, put it to your own grant application. Now, in my opinion, every band should be applying for grants and they should be doing it even from like their infancy, even from when they just start out. Because the more, obviously, you write these grant applications, the better you get at them. And the funny thing is, if you even start being successful with your grant applications, you're almost more likely to be more successful in future. Basically, you're gonna be given heaps of money to make like a metalcore album. Sounds pretty stupid, but it's real. and you can do it too. I've had friends before that are dancers, and basically the only way they can put on a show is if they get grant applications from the government. So they do like 3 big shows a year, and they get like $40,000 to $50,000 grants to put on these shows. And that's money they don't have to pay back. It's like, it's just money they get to use for their art, which is fucking sick. Now I know, you know, being the musician that you are, you're no stranger to hard work, I'm sure. Driving like fucking 10 hours to get paid $200 between the 5 of you. This is gonna be hard work. So I'll do my best to make it quick, sharp and short, but just kind of explain the way in which I thought about doing this application and why I said some of the things I said. Now, a lot of this, it's really honestly so painful even for me to read because I am writing about myself and my own band in like a third party way where I'm trying to like fluff us up, make us look really big, make us look really cool, basically make us look like a band that people want to give money to. So you need to do the same sort of mentality and write about your band as if they were like the best thing on planet Earth. Within reason, of course. imagine what these grant bodies do is they want to give money to artists. It's just up to us to prove to them that if they're going to give us thousands of dollars, that we're not going to squander it and we're going to do what we set out to do. Basically, the way I think about it is I think to myself, okay, what are the words I need to say? What is the evidence I need to give to these people to make them really believe that if they give me the money, it's going to go to where I say it's going to go and we're going to be successful? And I do that by providing evidence. So of like previous successes, and that can be anything. So for us, luckily it was things like, you know, previous EPs, it was things like touring, ARIA charting, things like that. It could be anything for your band. Even if you're like, okay, we got like 4 really good reviews on Triple J Unearthed, which propelled us into playing our first show at Wrangler to 20 payers and it went off without a hitch. And now we're going in to record our first EP. Whatever you can kind of like add to your application to basically say we've done this before and we're going to do it again, and if you give us money it'll enable us to do a better job of it this time. Because basically what you are as an artist to these grant bodies is a middleman, is someone that's going to be distributing the money that they give you to people like photographers, to your audio engineers, to your videographers. You really need to seem like you are the expert on what it takes to make your art, because they're not. And if you don't make it super super clear as to what it is you're going to be doing with the money, then they're not going to want to give you the money. And before I just jump into this application, one other quick example is the first grant we got, I think we applied for something around like $30,000 and we got a fraction of that. The $30,000 was for like the entire album from A to B for our first album, or at least what we budgeted for, Christ. And what ended up happening was they gave us a fraction of it because they said, well, we don't exactly know what you're going to be doing with the rest of the money. Even though I said $10,000 was for videos, X thousand was for audio recording, mix and mastering, X thousand was for photography, for like promo pictures. They were like, we don't know what you want to use the promo pictures for. And that was kind of bewildering to me a little bit, but I understood what they meant was I needed to actually say very specifically what I will be doing with the money, who I'll be paying, and what would be the reason for me giving them that money. How in fact would that help our band and how in fact would that help the project in some way. So I took that on board, and for this application that I wrote, it's quite almost painfully specific in some ways, which you're going to need to do for your grant application as well. All right, so let's just jump into it. I'm going to skim through it as quickly as I can, because it's honestly not that much writing that you have to do. The amount of words that you will need to write, probably around 2,000 to 2,500 in total. And then you're going to need to provide a bunch of supporting material, which is very important, which I'll get to at the very end. So basically what we have here, all the questions, these are the questions that are on the grant application. So obviously, what's the name of your album? Grave Mind, None Your Fucking Business, Album 2. Then you go to the summary of the project. Well, we're going to record, mix, and master 10 songs with artwork, marketing materials, music videos for the release of Grave Mind's second album. And then how we're going to distribute it, through what labels. Your artistic practice as relevant to the application, focusing on career highlights and key achievements, and no more than 2,400 characters. Because we all count in characters these days, right? So this is where you have to start looking at your band as if it's not really you, as if it's someone else, and then you start writing a really nice big fluff piece. So basically what we did was introduction from where we're from, when we started, basically saying we never seek the easy route. Since our formation, we've done 2 EPs, we've done this many albums, they've got this many sales, they've got this ARIA charting, and this is how many plays they've got on Spotify. A few cold hard facts at the start to say we mean business. And then you go on to say from the success of our first album, or whatever it is for you, first EP, first single, whatever, you say how many times you've toured, with what bands, and who you're basically affiliated and working with. Obviously, in your infancy of a band, it can be quite hard. You haven't really got a lot of people in your corner, and that can just be the reality of your band for a very long time, unfortunately. But if you've got booking agents, if you've got managers or anything like that, make sure you jot them down. And then talk about anything that you do that gives back to the community in a way that really isn't meant to benefit your band. If you do anything charity-wise, make sure you write that down as well. So we put the World's Greatest Shave, Dry July, Change the Record, and then anything about yourself as well. So I was told, obviously, to include the fact that I'm Aboriginal, and that's a big part of my identity as well. Obviously, these grand people, they want it to be diverse as well. So if you just say, we're 5 white dudes and we write metalcore music, good luck to you. But yeah, they're obviously looking for diversity, so that I think would help in some way as well. I'm not sure to what percentage. That is a spicy subject. I do not want to touch it. Okay, so this is the next part here. It says, are you working with other artists or creatives? Obviously, yes, you are, because you're going to be having a bunch of people involved in making your album. These are all kind of cut off. I'm sorry, it's just copy and pasted. But obviously, you've got your engineers, your artwork designers, your graphic designers, your video producers, public relations, anyone that's having anything to do with the album in some way where you're paying them, put them in the people that you're working with here, because they'll also be asking you how much you're paying them in just a second. The next one, about your project. Tell us about your project, outlining what you want to do, the creative rationale, the activity involved, and the key steps you'll undertake to deliver this in no more than 5,600 characters. So this is the part where you do a bit of a fluff at the start, I would say. Well, I've done this in the past anyway. Do a bit of fluff at the start. Give some reasoning as to why you are making the project, and be artistic about it. You are an artist. I don't care if you just write and beat down music. You are an artist. Don't listen to what your mum says. Write a little bit about why you want to do it, what it means to you about your music. So we wrote a little bit about the lyrical content, the way in which we want our fans to feel, and how they kind of connect with our music and how we like them to connect with our music. We talked a little bit about COVID, how that kind of fucked us, the reasoning behind why we're applying for the grant, why we need the money, because obviously in heavy music, it's touring to make an income and then using that income to produce the next album, a lot of grants, label advances and what have you. But that touring cycle, obviously, we got shafted on, so we're like, oh, we need money for this because we didn't make any from touring. Joke's on them. We barely make any money from touring. Okay. And then we write about why we're making an album. That might seem so stupid, but really, break it down. We say that we write music for people to unite them, and the fact that heavy music is such a powerful outlet for people who are commonly outcast in the community, and basically saying it's a healthy way for people to expel emotion. If you are an extreme band, try and write about why that doesn't carry over necessarily into who you are as a person. If your band's called Corpse Smasher 3000, from my experience, you're probably a bunch of very lovely people, but a grant body may not know that. So if you are an extreme band, tell them what we know in the industry. Tell them what we know in our genres of music, of extreme music, that, fans of extreme music are some of the most, caring and lovely people in the world. So we wrote that as well, basically to save our asses, so people don't just think we're some kind of crazy metal sadists or whatever. And then the same section, Then we break down exactly as to why this funding is important and what we're going to be doing with the money. So we basically said if we're successful, this is where the money will go and this is why it's going to these places, and break it down in the step by step. So I went from basically saying from like when the album's recorded, mixed and mastered, that's all pretty obvious, they know what that is. We talk about making the artwork and why the artwork's important, and then we talk about making the pre-order merchandise and why pre-order merch is important for heavy metal bands, because that's where we make most of our money from, it's not from the music itself. You talk about the importance of really good, you know, video production. Obviously you want your videos to look good because your fans, if they see a shitty video, they might just keep scrolling and not give a fuck. You basically break down where the money's going and why it's important for that. Try not to like make it too dumbed down, because these people, they aren't idiots, they just need to know that you're not an idiot. So keep it short, keep it brief, keep moving along. And then there's the activities. When are you doing these activities? Between what dates? Now these can obviously change. When you get the grant money, they don't like keep tabs on you non-stop. They're not like constantly asking what's going on. You know, you said you were going to do your video on this date and it's not done on this date. No, they want to have like a summation of how everything is at the very end of the project. So don't worry if these dates are kind of tentative, but write down tentative dates for everything you're doing. So we went from like recording, mixing, mastering, recording the live drums, the artwork creation, everything. Like we timelined it out and we'll say this is most likely when these events are going to take place. And every grant application will have like a specific timeline in which they want the project to take place and when they want it to finish. Obviously, you just put your dates in between that and then do it in that time. I don't know what happens if you don't do it in that time. I don't want to find out. And then the last part that you really have to write anything about is in this application, and this application was similar to the one I did a few years ago as well, even though it was a different body, is it asks you the primary outcome of your project and you get to select that. And that's where you look through, they'll give you a list. So this is quite nice, it's nice. It's just four separate ones, but sometimes they're 10, 15, they're insane. There's so many different things to pick from. If you want to record an album, obviously pick one that relates, you know, mostly to recording and writing an album. If you're doing touring or something like that, obviously, you use your best judgment here. For what I did, I picked arts and creativity are thriving. For projects supporting creation, capabilities, distribution, and reach. Now this is where I am glad the only thing my ADD brain sunk in when I went to school was how to write an essay. Because I think I do a decent job of answering the question, even though it's something that it's so kind of lofty. Like this project, this money that we need was to make an album. And the answer to the question they're asking is, how's this for projects supporting creation, capabilities, distribution, and reach? You're like, fuck. Break it down, literally like go through each of those words and then address them and try and tie that to the fact that you want to make an album. And then it's so corny, but like this is what I do. I just literally at the end of whatever my point is, will address the word. So la-di-da-di-da-da, we have already, you know, we've got a second album written. The process we've outlined is to push the boundaries and find nuance and create hit, right, creativity, la-di-da. And then it finishes off by saying, this method will increase our distribution and reach along with refining our process for creation and project-related capabilities. Like, what? But that's like, obviously that's taken into consideration all these things above here. Do your best. It bends my simple mind to really make this make sense. But pause the screen here and have a little read through what I've written and see if you can work out a better way. This might be one of the parts of the video where you go to yourself, you didn't answer the question there. I can't believe you got that grant. And to which I say, ha-ha. No, don't say that. You're basically trying your best to work out what they want to see nailed as part of this criteria here, and then try and give it a little bit of evidence. So like, you know, distribution is one of them. So we say, for the first time, we're going to be backed by an international label. This will increase our distribution and reach because it's going worldwide. Like, that's pretty cut and dry. So once you've got all that nicely written down, you've gone over it like maybe 50 to 60,000 times and you've sent it to your bandmates and they've gone through it 50 to 60,000 times themselves and found all your bloody spelling mistakes and grammatical errors. You're pretty much done with everything you more or less need to write. And then the next part you've got is the budget section. So you can't even, this is so like, God, this is gross. You can barely even read it. But in the budget section, they want you to write down the income that you're getting to help pay for this that's outside of the grant money. So don't ever apply for a grant and basically just say, well, the money we're getting to make this album with is just all from the grant money. Because I know for a fact that they look at that and they go, oh, fuck, you're not really dedicated then. Like, if we don't give you the money, this free money, then you're not going to make your project. You want to, I'd say at least 40 to 60% say the money is coming from somewhere else. The first application I ever did for a grant was, our income wasn't label advances. It was literally, you know, ex-member works at Coles, ex-member works at Crown Casino. Like, and that was where our income to make the project was. I think that's a really good way of showing that, like, come whatever may, you're going to be making this record or making this project or going on this tour. It gives them more confidence to say, well, fuck, they're going to do it regardless. This will clearly help them, and we can clearly see from everything they've listed in their application that they have the means of making this a reality. So you put in your income, where it's coming from, where you said advances, where you said, I deleted a bunch of stuff. You don't need to know that. Money's a bit rude. So I've just put, you know, advance, money we're projected to make from merchandise. So once you put in all your income where it's coming from outside of the grant, you go down to your expenses. And then this is where you actually put in where the money is going to specifically, and you write it down, and you write down what it is as well. So there was like a drop down box, and this is so, say, for production costs. Album recorded of 10 tracks by Scotty Simpson, recording and producing vocals, guitar, bass, synth, to be performed by Gravemind, and to be like, spell that out and mention where it's going and put the exact amount as well. It's very important. I went really over the top and got a bunch of budgets and quotes from all the people that are involved in this project, but they don't actually need them. You literally just need to fill out this form. It's really cool. These grant people, they do take you by your word, so don't take that for a ride, but you don't have to actually back all this stuff up with quotes. You can just write this stuff down. So as you can see here, all these things here are like project and production costs, right? But at the top here, we've got artist salaries, wages, and fees. I hate this. I hate writing this. I don't like it, because I know, even yourself watching this right now, you probably never paid yourself a wage for your band. Well, like, not at least until, I don't know, until what level you get to. I'll let you know when we get there. But what they want to see in these grant applications, I do know this for a fact, because I've spoken to someone on the board who looks over these applications, is they want to see that everyone's getting paid for their work. That includes members of your own band. They want to see that you're going to be, during the process of recording and making this album, that you're paying members what they call a per diem. So we just set a $50 per day per diem for individual members of Gravemind during recording. Sweet. And that is literally everything that you need to do for the three or four that I've applied for. All look pretty much the same as this. And when I rewrote this one, I basically just took the application I had from the very first time I applied and just kept reworking it. So I've already got like a kind of template that works for my band. I don't know specifically what it is, and I'm just telling you what my vibe is for what gets us these successful grant applications. And I, again, to surmise, I really just think it's basically, you need to prove yourself to be a capable middleman. So you need to prove yourself to be someone that, if they're going to give money to you, it's going to go where you're saying it's going to go, and it's going to help your band, and it's going to give back to the community. So, you know, I would also suggest, if you're making like an album in Australia, to have the people working on it, most of them, like pretty much like 90% of them, be from Australia, so not just sending money out overseas. They do this to stimulate the economy, they do this to keep people in work, and especially during COVID times as well. They definitely want to give this money to people in the industry. You as a band are basically the middleman, taking these funds and putting them where they need to go. So that's what you need to do in this application, I think, is just to prove yourself worthy of that. Back yourself to show that you've done the work before and it was successful in some way, and then explain as to why getting more money and doing another project is going to go the same way, if not better. And another great way of doing that specifically is by supplying supporting documents. So what we've gone through here, this is the same thing that every single person that applies for this grant is going to get. You know, obviously the content of this application is very important, but I also think that the supporting material is either as important or maybe even more important than all of this, because you're going to have a lot of bands saying the same thing in different ways that you are. There's only so many ways you can say, we're writing an album because it's really important and it's going to do really good things for us. Like, a lot of people are going to be writing that exact same application, so you need to zhuzh it up somehow, and you do that by supplying supporting material. Now, it's not on this document, but there were a bunch of links on the actual application that say things like, you know, supporting documentation may include music, like demos, it may include testimonials, it may include statistics. The most important ones that I have heard from people that check these applications is testimonials. So they are stupidly important. I supplied, I think, 3 on the first one and 4 testimonials on every application after that. What a testimonial is basically someone third party to your band just saying what they think about you and what they think about your achievements. Now, I'm going to show you Josh Merrills, Josh Redbeards. He's our label head. I'm sure he's happy for me to show you this. But here's a good one from Josh. So he has done the same thing that I would do, where he really, like, you know, fluffs us up. There's a lot of really nice things he's written in here. I don't know if they're all true. Well, he might still think they are, but I read them and I'm like, who the fuck are you talking about? But basically what the point of a testimonial is to say, these are legit guys. Here is how I've heard about them, and here's what their accomplishments are. When I've worked with them, here's what they've been like to work with, and, you know, here are all my props to them. That is what a good testimonial is, and you want about 3 or 4 of those to go ahead with your application. So I've just taken the document and I've spruced it up and made it look a little bit nice. As you can see, there's scratching here and nice little bordering. I did that in Photoshop, and so lucky for you, I've already done a video on how to teach you how to do Photoshop. So if you don't know, you can go watch that. Another thing I found important to provide was like bios as well. So we kind of do like a quick little side page of why we artistically chose to work with the people we work with, and we give examples as to their websites and, you know, their bodies of work or their showreel in the case of like a videographer or something like that. Because again, you're saying, okay, you give me $10,000 and I'm going to give $1,000 here and $2,000 there. I think it's also good to kind of show that these people that you're giving the money to are legitimate, hardworking business people as well. They have a place and a standing in the industry that you're working in. And then lastly, what's good to include, I think, is a statistic sheet about your band. This is really, really important. And I think this is why it's a good idea to be doing grant applications every time you possibly can. Because as you can see here, you can almost see every single time that I applied for a grant. Because every time I'd apply for a grant, I would go through all of our socials, all of our streamings, all of our like sales and profits, and I would total them all up. And then when I would do it again, I'd go, you know, 6 months later, I'd do the same thing again, and I put an increase in percentage, like how much it's gone up by, and I would include that in the most recent application, grant application I'd be sending off, or even label applications. So as a quick side note, I'll show you really quickly, these statistics, I use those when we applied for Grayscale. So this was a little resume EPK we did, and we got quite a few labels coming back to us wanting to work with us because they were really impressed by the little package we put together. So having those statistics is not only great for grant applications, because you're showing, basically you're proving to them, here is, you know, what we've done before and here's where we've come from and here's where we're going. But if you're applying for a label, obviously what they want to know is, can you make the money? So if you take nothing else from this video, make sure you're keeping tabs on your statistics, because then you can use them for grant applications and you can use them for label applications. You could use them for booking agent applications, pitching for endorsements. They're a great thing to have to add as part of this. Now, I will show you at some point how to make a nice looking label EPK resume type deal. That's another video. We're getting a bit sidetracked here, so I'll go back to it, because I did say this is going to be quick. And I think we're like at 20 minutes, so I'm very sorry. But yeah, anyway, to finish it all up for your grant application, I put a little thank you page in as well with some contact details and some links. You can open, I think it's Adobe Acrobat Pro. You open that and you can put clickable links on your PDF document. So something like that. I just think that's a nice little way to present and set yourself apart from all the other applications that everyone else is going to be getting that look exactly the same, hundreds and hundreds and hundreds of times over, is to make something like this, to provide some additional supporting material, which is, I think, is super, super crucial for you to be successful in your grant application. Cool. Hopefully that was relatively straightforward and not too painful. Like, I know it's dry, but whatever, man. If you get like $10,000, like, it was worth it. Hopefully. Subscribe and like and do all that stuff. See ya.